Hello and welcome back to another conspiracy theory video. I hope you are ready to jump back into the rabbit hole. And without further ado, here we go. Number 1. The Mandela Effect. Have you ever remembered something one way, and then all of a sudden, it's just changed? Well, how about the words to one of the most famous cartoons not sounding the same anymore? Well, you, my friend, are just experiencing the Mandela Effect. The term originated from Fiona Broom, who along with thousands of others believed that Nelson Mandela died in prison in the 1980s and not in 2013. Now, as South Africans, this doesn't click, as Mandela is South African and we clearly remember him passing away in 2013. However, there are other scenarios where the Mandela Effect has taken place. Here are a couple of examples that definitely shook me, and I'm going to start off with some logos. I will be showing you two images of one logo, and you're going to have a couple of seconds to decide which one looks right to you. And then I'm going to shock you and show you the actual correct one. And maybe just you, like me, will also be freaked out. That was pretty freaky. But now this is where it goes sideways for me. I'm going to be playing you a couple of clips and, well, you judge for yourself and tell me how weird this is.
Slave in the magic mirror, come from the farthest space. Through wind and darkness I summon thee. Speak! See thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
Sorry, did she just say magic mirror on the wall? I'm pretty sure it is mirror, mirror on the wall. Listen again.
Let me see thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
Famed is thy beauty.
Am one of those people that they say suffer from the Mandela effect. And I've been told that Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs by Walt Disney says magic mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all? And I know that's not true in the original, because this is the original, And if you will look very closely, you'll see in the second paragraph, "Mirror, mirror on the wall. Now who's the fairest one of all?" she asked. So I know I'm not crazy.
Star Wars, anyone?
Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father.
He told me enough. He told me you killed him.
No. I am your father.
Say what?
I am your father? Darth, I'm pretty sure it is Luke. I am your father.
The original VHS says, "Life is like a box of chocolates. Life is." Listen to the movie of the original VHS. Quiet.
You want a chocolate?
You want a chocolate?
I could eat about 1.5 million of these. My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates.
What the hell is that? Life was like a box of chocolates?
You never know what you're going to get.
I've seen this movie many times and it always says life is like. Here's proof.
Life.
The original VHS says life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. But the movie has changed for some reason.
Like that,
I don't know.
Some say the reason we experience this is because we live in a parallel universe and often they get crossed, and that's why we remember something one way and not the other. From what I've seen, scientists claim that it's got to do with our memory and a similar feeling to deja vu. However, I think it's pretty creepy and something else is going on here. Number 2. Aliens in crop circles. These strange patterns that appear mysteriously overnight in a farmer's field provoke puzzlement, delight, and intrigue among the press and public alike. The circles are mostly found in the United Kingdom, but have spread to dozens of countries around the world in past decades. The mystery has inspired countless books, blogs, fan groups, and even Hollywood films. Despite having been studied for decades, the question remains, who or what is making them? Some believe that aliens are using them as a guidance system, or to possibly mark our future spots for landing. The reason people think it's alien is due to the fact that there have been studies done on the crops, and what they discovered was a lengthening of the apical nodes which seemed to be the result of some kind of electromagnet or microwave energy exposure. This exposure caused the stalk to bend at various angles, sometimes as much as 90 degrees. Now, depending on the degree, without even killing the plants. This expulsion of the node sometimes affected only a single row of cells within the stalk, something that we do not currently have technology to recreate. Now, that is pretty mad. And while some have been able to recreate crop circles, none have been able to do it with such precision and in such a short time. For me, this is really strange. However, my doubt comes in with the fact that if aliens are definitely, well, it's not if, they definitely are far more advanced than we are, so why would they be using crop circles to navigate instead of heat beacons or whatever the case may be? Then again, I just might be an alien myself trying to debunk the belief in my race. Number 3. Drink water, become poisoned. Okay, so this one is pretty intense and goes a real long way. The idea in a nutshell is that governments put fluoride in our water supply in order to negatively affect huge populations, for their own financial gains of course. Fluoride is actually a strong tranquilizing disguise. Governments want their citizens to be just like zombies, and no, not the walking dead kind of zombies. Kellogg's, Nestle, Crest and other food companies, they all known as the fluoride mafia, they all in it. That fluoride dumping is secretly a weapon that is wrapped up in Illuminati interests. If you dig into why water fluoridation began, you find a convoluted, suspicious mess. According to the conspiracy theory, the name of the company with the biggest profits to be made from water fluoridation was Alcoa. The Alcoa company had an unlimited supply of toxic waste, a byproduct of aluminum, aka fluoride. At their lab, an Alcoa-sponsored biochemist did a test on rats that showed cavities were reduced with the fluoridated water and concluded that the case should be regarded as proved. Madness! In this historic moment in 1939, well, so the story goes, the first public proposal that the US should fluoridate its water supplies wasn't made by a doctor or dentist, but an industry scientist working for a company that was also threatened by fluoridate damage claims. The Tangle conspiracy gets even darker with comments on Reddit threads, such as Hitler used fluoride first, and they got this from the Nazis, Illuminati scum. The so-called fact that Hitler gave people in concentration camps fluoridate weight water to keep them docile and unable to resist Nazi power is used often by the anti-fluoridation brigade. Increasingly, water fluoridation has been rejected in local British areas. In 2014, yes, 2014, 6 years ago, Bolton refused to add fluoride to their water supply, with David Crosby, the MP for Bolton North East, likening it to a mass medication. That same year, Public Health England had to drop plans to fluoridate water in Southampton and parts of Hampshire because of fierce opposition from the Southampton City Council. But still, Public Health England fluoridation and the NHS website states that fluoride provides no significant health risk. Millions around the country still drink fluoridated water. So what do you guys think? Are we being controlled? Are we being manipulated? I think a definite yes to both of these questions. But not only with fluoride. Propaganda and advertising has become so blatant and in your face, it's easy to be distracted from the bigger problems in the world. Number 4. Chipotle E. coli. In 2016, fast casual burrito enthusiasts were left reeling when a string of E. coli outbreaks were recorded at Chipotle outposts across the nation. Eventually, the bacteria tapered off. Inevitably, the conspiracy theories rolled in. There is an absurd amount of ground to cover, but the conspiracy folder basically consists of GMO megacorporations, the biotech mafia, purposefully infiltrating and lacing Chipotle's meat with the bacteria in an attempt to bring the carnitas slinger down from the inside. Chipotle is one of the most outspoken opponents of GMOs, so it makes sense for it to be a primary target. Well, if any of this stuff even makes sense in the first place. A spokesperson from the Chipotle politely delivered a statement to the Thrillist. We have seen some of those conspiracy theories, but haven't seen any evidence to support them. Sounds suspicious to me. Number 5. Sugary death. If you've ever visited the dentist or called a promo for The Biggest Loser, you know sugar, or at least the kind we eat. Isn't that great for you? This is no made-up urban legend. What is a theory, and aptly referred to as the sugar conspiracy, go figure, is that sugar might be even worse for our bodies than most people know about, and its true effects are being covered up by the government. Surprise, surprise, our dear old friend the government. The claims trace their source back to an Australian scientist and professor of nutrition, John Yudkin. In his 1972 book, Pure White and Deadly, Yudkin states, if only a small fraction of what we know about the effects of sugar were to be revealed in relation to any other material used as a food additive, that material would promptly be banned. And essentially claims that sugar, not fat, is the prime driver behind obesity and associated ailments like diabetes and heart disease. At this point, the story basically delves into a familiar narrative. Sugar is kept relatively alive and well by lobbyists and bankrupt corporations, making sure the public at large doesn't catch a gander of sugar's true dangers, and ensures that the processed sugar remain in the majority of mass-consumed foods. In a sign that these conspirators may actually be onto something, the US government has cracked down on sugar over the past year, and a wave of recent books or authors have picked up where Yudkin left off. It's no coincidence no sugar diets have been on the rise, which really sucks because Fun Dip is delicious, if not, potentially deadly too. Number 6. New Coke vs. Old Coke. Marketers are known to pull some suspect stunts in order to garner attention and build hype. For example, some say Calvin Harris and Taylor Swift's feud is all media manipulation to promote all parties. Maybe they are right, but in this case, Coca-Cola introduced its new formula in April of 1985, and the public pretty much hated it. When the cola giant readily switched back to its old formula, too much fanfare of course, some cynics claimed that the plan was to dupe the public with a faulty new product all along, just to get people interested in the old cola once again. Even for a company as big as Coke, It would be too much of a risk to develop, manufacture, and promote a new product simply to get people worked up, then bank on them returning to an existing product. Ex-Coke president Donald Q countered the query saying, "We're not that dumb, and we're not that smart." Sounds about right to me. Which Coke do you guys prefer? The old Coke or the new Coke? What about Coke Zero? Coke Light? Cherry Coke? Oh, the list is endless, guys. Number 7. Slender Man. Ask those who know best about what makes this legend so frightening, and you're likely to hear some version of this response. Slender Man is scary, not because of what you know about him, but because of what you don't know. One late spring day in 2014, three girls entered the woods in Waukesha, Wisconsin. Two walked out unharmed. A 911 call made not long after that revealed the hazy outline of a vicious attack. One of the girls had been found by the side of the road, covered in blood, having crawled there to get help. In the days and weeks that followed, details emerged that were no less disturbing. The three girls, all 12 years old, were best friends. The victim, she had been stabbed 19 times with a 5-inch blade and had barely survived. After being taken into police custody, the other two girls told interrogators what happened. They had lured the friend into the woods to kill her so that they could appease someone called the Slender Man. The girls believed the only way to appease the Slender Man was to make a blood offering. So, they spent months plotting the death of their friend, Peyton Lutner, who was also 12 years old. In May 2014, they lured Lutner into some nearby woods, telling her they wanted to play hide and seek. Once in the woods, Geyser stabbed Lutner 19 times while Weir urged her on. The Slender Man is an unnaturally tall, skinny figure who's often depicted without a face. Sometimes he's pictured with extra limbs or tendrils coming out of his body. He lurks in wooded areas and lures children to him so he can kill them and then eat them. People often feel they see a Slender Man, but when they turn around, he's gone. Now, Slender Man is the perfect example of a good urban legend. He's just vague enough to paint all kinds of horrors onto his blank canvas. He also seems not to be camera shy, which has resulted in many sightings. I'm going to play you a couple of clips here, and you can tell me what you think about them.
What the heck? Who's there? People trying to pull pranks and stuff. I know Slenderman isn't real. Did anyone else see that? Not really anyone else, I'm all alone. But what the heck? Holy crap! Oh my god! Oh! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa, hey, who is that? Was that? People are trying to pull jokes, I don't see him. Where is he? Is that him? Is that him? Oh crap! Oh! Oh my god!
I get absolute goosebumps when I see some of these clips, and to think, what is it like? You know, is it real? I don't know. I do believe some of them have been faked as well, so it's hard to tell which is fake and which is real these days. But you know, I've always been a firm believer that a person's imagination can be the most powerful artistic tool in the world. However, for you to create something, you need to have some sort of a basis that resembles such a creature or supernatural being. I don't really know what to make about it, but I would love to read your comments below. So when you go to sleep tonight, look over to your cupboard or behind your door and give the Slender Man a thumbs up.